We're your host. I'm Christina.
And I'm Gabe.
And today we're going to be making Easter breakfast foods. So some of the things we're going to be making today are...
granola, homemade with yogurt, granola yogurt parfait.
Yes, and then we're going to teach you how to make some simple French toast. And then finally...
a coffee drink called Cafe Batido, which in Spanish means beaten coffee. And you'll see what that means a little bit later.
Yes, it's pretty delicious. So first things first, let's get our granola in the oven because it takes about 45 minutes to bake. And we want to get that going so that we can let it cool and make our parfaits.
Okay, tell me what to do.
All right, so what we're going to start with is 3 cups of oatmeal. And you want regular oats. You want to be sure not to get the instant oatmeal. For whatever reason, I guess the instant oatmeal cooks faster and it's like pieces of oatmeal, so it gets kind of soupy and it's hard to eat if you make granola with it. So if you see one that says 5-minute oats or old-fashioned oats, that's fine, just not the instant. So we've got 3 cups of oats, and then we're going to add a mixture of seeds and nuts. So we're going to do 1 cup of pumpkin seeds, which are also called pepitas. And then we're going to do 1 cup of sunflower seeds. And with all these seeds and nuts, it's up to you. Generally, you want to do unroasted and unsalted since we're going to roast them. But if, like, the pumpkin seeds, all I can find at the store are the roasted ones, so I just roll with it and it's been fine. But you can try the unroasted if you want. Okay. Then we're going to do 1 cup of coconut flakes. And if you can't find coconut flakes, you can use the shredded coconut that you find on the baking aisle. That's totally fine. And then 1 cup of slivered almonds. And all of these are interchangeable. If you would rather have pecans, you can use that. If you'd rather have peanuts, you can do that. It doesn't have to be these nuts, these seeds. You just want to keep the ratios the same. That's it for that. If you want to give that a stir, I'm going to start making...
with what? The spoonchula?
What is a spoonchula?
This is a new kitchen tool that we have called a spoonchula. It's a combination between a spoon and a spatula.
It's pretty cool.
So should I use that to stir it with?
That works. And so we're going to mix the dry ingredients together, and then we have some wet ingredients. What I have in the bowl here is 1/2 cup of coconut oil. And you can see coconut oil, depending on the temperature, is either a solid, like this white one, or it's liquid when it's a little warm. So we're going to take it in the liquid form. If it's not already liquid, you can just pop it in the microwave for like 30 seconds. And to that, we're going to add 3/4 cup of maple syrup. There we go. And then we're going to add 1/2 cup of light brown sugar. And give that a little stir. And again, just like the mix in here, it's totally interchangeable. If you don't have coconut oil, you can use olive oil or regular vegetable oil. It does not matter. Coconut oil is just my preference. All right. That's nice and blended up. I'm going to pour this over the granola, and you want to give it a stir while I do that?
While you do that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And we're just going to coat... you can certainly do this by yourself, but it's helpful to have 2 people.
I'm gonna wait. I can't do it while you're doing that.
There we go. And we'll just give it a good stir and make sure all of the pieces are coated.
Yeah, I just need a second to do that, so that's what I'm doing right now. Make sure it gets all blended up. Please bear with me. Little sugar nugget in there. Okay. That looks pretty good for our purposes here today.
So okay. Once all the pieces look shiny and they're coated, you transfer it to a baking sheet lined with parchment paper. We have one of those over here. And you just pour it out onto the baking sheet. And you want to try to spread it as evenly as possible.
Okay.
We're going to put this in a 300 degree oven for 45 minutes, stirring about every 15 minutes, and then we'll have nice and toasty granola. So I'm going to stick this in the oven. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
Your extraordinary future begins at Wingate University with more than 35 undergraduate majors and graduate and professional programs in the health sciences, business, and education. Wingate University's enrollment has mushroomed and construction has skyrocketed in the past two decades. And Wingate is the sixth best value in the South, according to U.S. News and World Report. Most importantly, Wingate graduates get jobs. They're working all over the Carolinas and the U.S. Major in a great life at Wingate University.
All right, we're back. We got the granola in the oven, mm-hmm. and we're getting ready to make some French toast, which will be very good. And we want to thank the Union County Agricultural Center for letting us use their test kitchen, as always. It's fantastic. And we invite you to visit us on social media, Facebook, FoodU, and also on the Wingate University YouTube channel.
Yes, so French toast.
Mm-hmm. Oui, oui.
You can make it with all different kinds of bread. You can make it with French bread. A lot of people make it with like day-old French bread that's like thick and crusty and really nice. You can also make it with plain sandwich bread, and that's what I grew up eating as a kid. My dad would make this for us all the time. It was a special treat on the weekends. Sometimes on the weekdays if we could convince him to get up early with us.
Uh-huh.
Usually weekends. So today we're going to make it using plain honey wheat sandwich bread.
Okay.
We'll see how that goes.
Tell me what to do.
All right. First things first, we're going to make our batter to dip the bread in. So we're going to crack two eggs, and we can do it right into our pan.
Okay.
I'll let you go ahead and do that. And I'm going to put a couple pats of butter over here in the pan while you're doing that.
Okay.
And get that going. With French toast, you take the bread and you dip it in this wet mixture, and you cover it on both sides. And then you put it in a buttered pan and sear it and kind of cook it. Doesn't take very long. Super good.
What do I do after the eggs?
1 cup of milk.
So cream, this cream right here?
That's, oh,
that's milk. Whole milk.
Yep.
A cup of it?
Yep.
And my eyeball it.
I'll grab you a measuring cup. Hold on 1 second. There you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. But I'm glad you said that with the cream, because with French toast, it doesn't have to be milk. You can use half and half or cream or any kind of soy milk or nut milk. It just needs to be some type of dairy liquid.
What is nut milk?
Like cashew milk or almond milk.
Mm. Okay. Now do I start whisking this up?
Let's put a little bit of salt.
Okay.
I'll grab that for you.
Right.
There you go.
You're trying to trick me.
I know. Is it working?
Yeah. Okay.
All right, and then a tablespoon of vanilla. You can eyeball that.
I'm eyeball that.
Okay. I'm just melting butter over
table
here.
Table or tea?
Table.
Table, there it went.
There you go. And then a teaspoon of cinnamon.
Tea or tea?
Tea.
Okay.
Teaspoon.
I'm eyeball it.
All right.
Boom, boom. Okay.
Looks good. And then grab your whisk and whisk it together. And you want to do this in a shallow pan. You can do it in a bowl and then pour it into like a pie pan. That would be just fine.
I'm trying to be careful not to splatter. I'm just kind of vibrating my arm a little bit like a. Then I'm going to get into it a little bit more. It smells good. It smells like the cereal Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
That's kind of what French toast reminds me of. All right. Butter's melted. I've got my heat on medium high. And I'm going to grab a plate here for our finished French toast.
Finished.
When it's all cooked.
Oh, I see. There we go. I'm making a mess.
That's perfect. So you can see everything's mixed together.
I made a mess. Look, give me 1 second. Okay. All right. That's gross. All right. There we go. Okay.
All right, so everything's mixed together. And
I'll get that.
All right.
Yes.
We're gonna take a piece of bread.
Okay.
okay, put one side down,
yep.
Soak it, flip it over. Gotta use your hands, it's gonna get dirty.
I am.
Flip it over.
This will be good for the kids.
Pick it up, let it drip. Mm. Shake.
Yep.
Put it in this pan. That's it. And do it again.
Okay.
And you can hear the little sizzle when it hits the heat. I'm gonna grab a spatula real quick. I do have some tongs for you for that. It was too messy for you, I forgot. You don't want to move it around. I'm kind of antsy when I cook things and I like to move them, but you should just let it chill out for a minute and get a good sear on one side.
Okay.
All right, there you go.
Yeah.
And depending on the size of your pan, you can do 2 to 4 pieces. This is more like a 2-piece pan. Or if you have a skillet, that would work too. And we're gonna do about 2 to 3 minutes per side.
I like mine extra brown.
Me too. I don't like soggy.
We'll let it go.
All right. All right. Okay. It's starting to smell like it's getting kind of done. So we're gonna give that first one flip over.
Floppy.
It is a little bit. There we go. It's got a nice brown
crust
on the outside, like a good piece of toast.
That one looks even better.
It does. We'll flip that over, and you're still keeping it on medium high. Okay. Be careful, the butter's still in the pan. It splatters a little bit.
Talk to me.
And I'm gonna let that chill out. So, with our French toast, we're gonna make a maple whipped cream. Doesn't that sound good?
Uh-huh.
So, I like powdered sugar on my French toast, and I like whipped cream too, and I thought it'd be fun to make a sugary whipped cream instead.
Okay.
So, I've got some whipped cream in the fridge, actually in the freezer, in a bowl if you want to grab that. And instead of using a mixer to make the whipped cream today, we're going to beat it by hand. And that might sound intimidating, but it only takes a couple minutes. It's not that hard. You just got to have some good arm strength for a little bit.
Is this bowl yours too?
Yes.
Where do you mean to be?
Right here.
All right.
So a tip when you're making homemade whipped cream or handmade whipped cream is to pop your bowl in the freezer for like 10 or 20 minutes before you make it. And by having that nice and cold, it helps the cream thicken up faster. So we're gonna put that whole thing in there. 1 cup or 8 ounces of whipped cream. And then we're gonna grab our clean dry whisk and we're just gonna start beating it. And it's gonna take like 2 to 3 minutes, and you want to beat pretty hard.
Is this good?
Yep. You can probably even go faster.
I'm trying.
And I'll check the other side of my French toast here. Yep. Our first French toast is looking done. So I'm gonna pull these off the pan. Right. There you go. Those look nice and perfect, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
There we go. And I'm gonna grab some more butter, get it in my pan, finish out this French toast. Gabe's gonna keep beating the whipped cream and we're gonna take a break and be right back.
Planning your next step in life? Come complete your education in a dynamic, caring environment at Wingate University. Enrollment and construction have skyrocketed in the past 2 decades as students pursue challenging and rewarding degrees in fields like the health sciences, business, and education. U.S. News and World Report has named Wingate University the 6th best value in the South. Visit one of our 3 great campuses, Wingate, North Carolina, Hendersonville, or Charlotte, or check us out at wingate.edu. Major in a great life at Wingate University.
So we're finishing up this French toast right here, and Gabe, how's that whipped cream going?
It's whipped.
It's awesome. Hold the whisk up and show them this. You see how the peaks are stiff, or it's stiff on the whisk? That means it's ready. So we're in a good place with that.
Okay.
So now what we want to do is drizzle in about 3 tablespoons while you're whisking.
Okay.
So, multitasking challenge here. And while he's doing that, this French toast recipe is enough for 8 slices of bread or 4 people with 2 slices each. So if you want to make more, you can just double the recipe. If you want to make half, since there's 2 eggs in it, you can half it and make enough for 2 people instead of 4. And that looks awesome. I'm going to grab another plate real quick. Let's see. Turn my burner off before I forget. plate up this second French toast. There we go. And I think it's time to check our granola real quick. What do you think?
Okay.
All right.
If you could do that, I'll move some of this stuff.
I will. So when we're checking our granola, let's see. You want to look for where it's starting to brown on the edges. And then what I like to do is just scoop it from the outside in and mix it up that way. The outer edges always seem to get done first, and the middle not so much. So I like to kind of swap that out. And you can certainly pull it out of the oven if you want to. I just like to leave it in. There we go. And then kind of smooth it back out. And that's got about 20 more minutes. So we're gonna put some water on to boil for our cafe batido. And then when we come back, we're gonna make our coffee. We're gonna assemble our parfaits. And we're gonna dress up our French toast. We'll see you in a minute.
What is Wingate? A thriving university nestled in a quiet community near Charlotte. Named sixth best value in the South by US News & World Report. Leading the way in the health sciences with pharmacy, PA studies, and nursing. What is Wingate? Big enough to offer 22 NCAA sports, small enough to attract the best and brightest in the world. What is Wingate? Wingate is you. Wingate University, major in a great life.
Welcome back. Once again, we want to remind you to check us out on social media, Facebook, FoodU, and the Wingate University YouTube channel. And thank you again to the Ag Center for letting us use this test kitchen.
Absolutely. So we're back. Our granola has got about 10 minutes left, and we're gonna start on our cafe batido, which, as Gabe said, means beaten coffee, which means, guess what?
Beat it.
Time for more whisking. So awesome, just like the whipped cream. So beaten coffee, I found out recently, it's also called an Indian cappuccino. And you make it with instant coffee, you make it with sugar, and boiling water or warm milk, and that's it. So what's important about this recipe is it's equal parts sugar and equal parts instant coffee. And what I'm doing today is a quarter cup of each. And that will make about 4 espresso cups, so enough for 4 people. And another beautiful thing about this recipe is if you go ahead and make this, you can store this in the fridge and make a coffee whenever you want for about a week. So what we've got here is the sugar and coffee. I'm just gonna mix it up a little bit. And I've got some water that's almost boiling here. And we're just gonna put a splash in, like just enough to start to melt the coffee and get it to form a paste. And this is totally an eyeballing thing. Sometimes it's a teaspoon and sometimes it takes a tablespoon. And you just gotta kinda watch it. Still a little crumbly, so I'm gonna add a little bit more water. There we go. And I wanna get the coffee out of the whisk. There we go. And what we're gonna do with this is literally beat it until it's light and creamy and frothy in texture.
You may go a little bit?
Yeah, go for it.
It might go and whisk.
And what I like to do when I'm whisking like that.
For some reason, when my hand moves like this, it makes me feel like I'm doing it faster.
It's not. One helpful tip when you're whisking like that is to keep turning the bowl while you're whisking it. You'll cover more ground while you're whisking. And you've got like another minute to go.
It smells good.
It does. Very good.
It'd probably be good just to eat it. Or put it over the French toast.
Could drizzle it on your ice cream. Mm-hmm. While you're doing that, I'm going to grab a couple espresso cups for when we're done. Let's see. It's going to be, it's like medium brown right now.
You want to do a little more?
You got to do it till it's like.
It looks like cake batter.
Tan. Yeah.
Ugh,
while I'm doing this, do you want to give the granola a stir? Check on it.
Do I want to?
Will you?
Yes. And yes, I want to.
So once you make the granola, you can keep it in an airtight container on the counter for about 2 weeks. I haven't really tried it longer than a week. It doesn't last longer than that in our house, but the recipe or protocol for those types of recipes is about 2 weeks. And I don't recommend keeping it in the fridge because it gets soggy. And you can tell this Cafe Batido is lightening up in color. We're almost there. I had this recipe for the first time when I was in Argentina a couple years ago. And I was visiting a friend down there, and their mother made this recipe for us for afternoon tea, and it was the best coffee I had ever had in my life. And I was very excited to come back and make it myself.
Looks good.
Thank you. So we're almost there. I'm gonna beat this for about 30 more seconds. We're gonna pull our granola out of the oven and let it cool for a little bit. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, we'll assemble our parfaits, we'll pour the coffee, we'll dress the French toast, and we'll finish it.
Your extraordinary future begins at Wingate University. With more than 35 undergraduate majors and graduate and professional programs in the health sciences, business, and education, Wingate University's enrollment has mushroomed and construction has skyrocketed in the past 2 decades. And Wingate is the 6th best value in the South, according to U.S. News & World Report. Most importantly, Wingate graduates get jobs. They're working all over the Carolinas and the U.S. Major in a great life at Wingate University.
Welcome back. We got our granola out of the oven here, and Christina's going to start working on the coffee and assembling the French toast dish. And I'm going to start making these parfaits with yogurt, Greek yogurt. You can use whatever kind of yogurt you want to use. Granola, and then I'm going to top it with some fruit.
Sounds good. And what kind of, I know you said Greek yogurt, but do you use fruit yogurt or can you use?
I think if it were me, I would use a non-flavored yogurt just because there's sweetness and flavor in the granola and in the fruit, but that's up to you. I did eat some, recently I ate some of your granola with a sweetened yogurt, and I put some jam in it too, and it was too sweet. So, but it's up to you. It's up to whoever's making it.
Sounds good.
All right, right.
And this granola, I'm not sure if we mentioned or not, but it makes about 7 cups, so that's about 14 servings. So it'll last a couple people a whole week. Mm-hmm. All right, so my Cafe Batido is done, and I'm gonna go ahead and assemble my French toast a little bit. So we've got some of this maple whipped cream that we're gonna put on the top. There we go. Whoop. And then I'm gonna grab syrup. Have these cute little pitchers that I like to put syrup in. And then I'm gonna grab a couple strawberries and slice them up for the top.
You know, the word parfait is French for perfect.
Hmm.
And I'm thinking these, my parfaits are not gonna be parfait.
But taste parfait.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Something cute to do with strawberries, if you take your paring knife and you cut them, but you only go to like right before the cap, then you can make little slices in it. And then you can take it and just kind of push it apart.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that cute? And then you can decorate the top of your French toast with it. So those are all done. Might sprinkle a couple blueberries on here. There we go. And then.
Will you top that one off with some fruit?
I will. We'll put some blueberries. We'll do another strawberry. I love strawberries. There we go. We have these cute little tall spoons for the parfaits. And then with the Cafe Batido, I'm gonna take a generous tablespoon of our mixture. Put it in the bottom of a cup. Just like that. And then I'm gonna grab our boiling water. Excuse me. And while I pour it in, I'm going to stir it. There we go. And it's about a quarter cup of water to a tablespoon of this coffee. So you can certainly use a bigger cup if you want to, but it is very strong. And then we'll do that for the second cup. There we go. Top this little guy with some fruit real quick.
Do that trick again.
Yeah. I think it makes it look pretty. There we go. And our beaten coffee. And we are done. We have French toast with maple whipped cream and syrup. We have homemade granola yogurt parfaits and beaten coffee. And that sounds like a fantastic Easter breakfast.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Thank you again, Union County Agricultural Center. And thank you, Christina, for those delicious recipes.
Thank you for your help. We'll see you next time.